back to the show. 5 months into our national experiment with toddleracracy, our 70-year-old, 3-year-old in chief hasn't managed to cram his destructive agenda through Congress. So, yay! But while the legislative branch's baby-proofing is holding up, the executive side still offers Donald Trump unfettered access to all the matches, oily rags, and flammable chemicals he needs to burn down our society. His latest co-arsonist? Apple-cheeked hate goblin Jefferson Beauregard Sessions.
Changes are coming to the drug policy in this country after the Attorney General announced a tough crackdown. Jeff Sessions ordering federal prosecutors to charge drug offenders with the most serious crimes they can, carrying the maximum punishments, reversing an Obama-era push for more leniency for nonviolent offenders.
Sessions doesn't realize that prison sentences are like penises. Longer isn't always better. 7 inches? Sure. 56 inches? That is not good for anyone. Only J-Bo Sessions could look at America's current incarceration rates and say this.
I'm getting worried we're not locking more people up.
Locking up everyone with a pulse was the kind of brilliant idea, like stirrup pants, that could only be born in the heyday of crack. Back then, my generation was reeling from the twin scourges of drugs and nonstop anti-drug PSAs.
Just say no.
With the LA Lakers, and we're here to say that the drugs are killing every day. Cocaine and crack, it's all got to go. We got to learn to just say no.
I got too high and hallucinated a bunch of giants rapping at me. Cool! Of course, LA's actual rappers saw the darker side of Nancy's campaign.
In Los Angeles, the war on drugs has so escalated that police last night began using a tank.
Mistaken identities in some cases, so you never knew when they was gonna roll the battle ram up in your mama house.
So you had Nancy Reagan sitting next to Daryl Gates conducting what was in essence urban warfare.
Okay, that is not how the First Lady showed up at Mr. Drummond's house.
I'm Nancy Reagan. Forgive me for dropping in on you like this.
Well, Ms. Reagan, I'd like to introduce my family. This is Kimberly, my daughter, and my 2 sons, Willis and Arnold.
Wait, those are your sons? Call in the battering ram! But the worst weapon in the decades-long quagmire on drugs were mandatory minimum sentences, America's worst idea since mandatory farming jobs.
Whenever I give a mandatory minimum, I'd say about 80% of the time, I think it's unjust.
I sentenced Shane Taylor 25 to life for a nonviolent third offense, and I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
Clarence tells me that the FBI came to his college classroom and pulled him out of the classroom and arrested him for possession with intent to distribute cocaine. There was absolutely no cocaine introduced into evidence. There was no scientific evidence, no fingerprints, nothing.
I just couldn't believe that when the judge told me that 3 life sentences running concurrent.
Don't worry, there's a happy ending. President Obama commuted Clarence's sentence after a mere 2 decades. Clarence went home and started mentoring middle school students while they mentored him on what the internet is. Oh my God, there's a black Twitter. Thousands of stories like that are why criminal justice reform is one of the few precious things that the left and right can agree on. It's an issue that unites Rand Paul and Cory Booker, Paul Ryan and Bernie Sanders, and I shit you not, Charles Koch and Snoop Dogg.
He got a whole lot of time and, you know, for the crime, it just didn't fit.
Snoop Dogg, if he's willing to roll up his sleeves and work for this, then welcome to the party. God bless you.
That's what everyone says when Snoop shows up at their party. But of course, there's always that one asshole who doesn't RSVP and instead calls the cops.
In the last Congress, a bipartisan group of senators sought to make meaningful progress with sentencing reform proposal. Unfortunately, those efforts were derailed by the obstruction of guess who? Then Senator Sessions.
Putting Jeff Sessions in charge of criminal justice is like putting that 5th dentist who never agrees with the other 4 in charge of all our teeth. Nobody knows why Jefferson is obsessed with the war on drugs. Maybe he just likes reenacting old battles that he lost. Or maybe it stems from the time he experimented with a mysterious drug that wound up shrinking him down to his current fun size stature. Whatever the reason, Sessions insists his one handcuff fits all policy is the answer to the opioid epidemic.
In 2015,
More than 52,000 Americans died from a drug overdose. That's a stunning number. According to a report by the New England Journal of Medicine, the price of heroin is down, its purity is up.
The New England Journal of Medicine. Don't let your boss catch you reading something so facty. You better keep that hidden inside your copy of the Alabama Journal of Baseless Claims. I guess Jeff missed the 1994 article declaring that the government assault on illicit drugs has proved to be a costly failure. That's why governors have been trying new solutions like reforming mandatory minimums and legalizing marijuana. Humane, sensible measures that give Aunt Pity Pat the vapors.
We need grown-ups in charge in Washington to say marijuana is not the kind of thing that ought to be legalized.
Jefferson Beauregard, attacking states' rights? Your ancestors must be rolling in their statues. It's like Trump nominated a VHS tape of Reefer Madness to run his Justice Department.
Good people don't smoke marijuana. This drug is dangerous. You cannot play with it. It's not funny. It's not something to laugh about.
Oh, no, there you did it. Everybody's laughing and coughing and spilling bong water everywhere and then laughing more about the bong water. Hey, you know who also smokes marijuana? Sick people. It helps with chronic pain, which may be why hospitalization rates for opioid dependence and abuse dropped on average 23% in states that legalized medical marijuana. It's what the kids call wake and bake. Bake as in smoking some pot, wake as in not dying from a heroin overdose. Face it, nobody's with you on your Make America Incarcerate Again mission, Dobby. Let's hope today's rumors are true and that your cranky boss is about to throw a dirty sock at you and set you free. Otherwise, we're gonna have a serious overcrowding problem in Azkaban. We'll be right back.